Assalamu alaikum. I have a question for you. Do you sometimes find yourself not knowing the basic things about the deen? I mean, sometimes someone might ask you a question and you're kind of stumped for an answer. Don't you wish that you had the answers to some of the basic things that you have to do as a Muslim day to day? If so, then perhaps you may be interested in studying your deen. We have an Islamic studies program, and if you'd like to join it, you can find more information on it by clicking the link below and joining our Telegram group. And if you like it, you can register for the first year. And hopefully we see you on the other side. Assalamu alaikum. Peace.
So inshallah ta'ala, just to remind, because reminder benefits and we have some new faces, we mentioned that from the etiquettes of a class is that you must be sitting at the front. It's not from good manners to be sitting up against the wall or to have our legs stretched out. I have no problem if you guys get chairs. There's many chairs around the masjid. I have no problem. But you have to come close. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's companions were one time sitting apart in the masjid. And they were sitting in the Prophet's masjid. There was no shade. The sun was blazing in the middle of the day. It was really burning them. So try to sit against the walls to get some shade. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in that blazing heat, still told them, come together in the front. Because you have to be united. And part of unity, what? Is us being together. People talk about the ummah is disunited. We can't even sit next to each other. When we stand in a row in salah, we can't even be straight. We can't even be united in a row. We wonder why there's so many problems in the ummah. So you have to come. And this is, inshallah, something that I want you guys to do without me having to tell you. If you come to the class, just come to the front. Just come to the front, inshallah ta'ala, as this is the etiquettes and the manners of a class. And this is etiquettes with knowledge. And if you have etiquettes with knowledge, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you some of His knowledge. He'll give you some of it. Does that make sense? Because you can put in all the effort that you want, brothers and sisters. You can put in all the effort that you want to learn. There are people that will learn, that will go study for 20 years. They come back, they haven't learned. You know why? Because the foundation of this chapter, this part of our deen, the chapter of knowledge, the foundation of it is whether Allah gives you tawfiq. Yes, you memorize. Yes, you study. Yes, you come, you travel, you do all of this. But the foundation of whether you actually get knowledge or not is if Allah decides to give it to you. And Allah will decide to give, Allah will give it to you based on the way you ask for it. You see, it's very important, inshallah ta'ala.